Good day, viewers. This is Triple A of Sierra Network, and today we're in the company of His Excellency David Vandy.
Oh man, how I wish.
I know, right?
Thank you so much for having me.
Okay, you're welcome, sir. We want to say thank you because you lend us a little bit of your time, and today we're going to talk to our folks out there. And so we don't know where we're going, but I guess at the end of this talk, it's not an interview because I just took his seat. This is what he does. And today, we just switch over.
I know. It's like you're always quizzing somebody. People, and today you're being quizzed.
Yeah, we just switch seat because actually this is his seat. But hey, today he's on the other side.
I know.
How are you doing, sir?
Well, as you can see, I'm doing great. And by the grace of God, things are fine, but it could get better.
That's true. Let me say, I know you have a long list of what you do. I don't want to start and maybe I forgot something. Can you please tell us? And please, don't skip any out. Just give us the list just like that.
Wow, that's quite a lot.
I know.
Okay, my life in general is that I do radio broadcasting. Okay. I've been doing that for a very long time. Started way back in 1990 with the first FM radio station in Sierra Leone, and that is the Atlantic Broadcasting Corporation, FM 94. I was the first Sierra Leonean to work on radio after midnight. Because we had just one radio station at that time, which was the SLBS, the National Radio and Television, that closes at midnight. And when FM 94 came on board, we started working after midnight. So I was the first person to do that. So you can imagine when people were going to sleep, I had to keep them up from 12 o'clock to 2 p.m. to 2 a.m. in the morning. Okay. And it was very, very successful because I kept them up, and all these pubs were calling me here and there. And so I got my way into radio, trained by two British broadcasters, Martin Davis and Jackie Chambers. Those are the people that actually gave me my first broadcasting lessons. And then after that, after the war, after the coup of 1992, I was drafted into the National Service, wherein I worked with the SLBS at that time, radio and television. And I was hosting the Wiki Waki Show, a very popular radio show.
You just took my mind away back.
Yeah. And then I got into television, started the musical mix. Respect to King Milan, who is now hosting that particular show. It was a big hit. You know, I started my first television drama, like sitcoms, which was a comedy called TV Productions at that time. And when I left the SLBS, it was changed to One Port. That is what is called One Port right now, you know. Being in that, and I was also hosting shows, you know, started hosting shows and all this. And then when I left the SLBS during the war in 1997-98, you know, after the AFRC thing, I worked with Radio Democracy FM 98.1. Okay. You know, that transition took us through the war. And after the war, I got drafted into the United Nations. I was called to work for the United Nations Radio in Sierra Leone. I was hosting a lot of programs, producing, and I became the programs coordinator for the United Nations Radio in Sierra Leone. And I love the United Nations, and you know, doors were opening. You know, I was given a job to become become the general manager of Sky Radio, 106.6 FM in Freetown. And I took the opportunity. It was a very big challenge, you know, to leave the United Nations and come and offer private radio station. But, you know, I wanted to do something for my country, you know, for my people. I said, okay, yeah, I've worked, the war is over, so let me see how I can be able to bring some more young people together. And I took up that job and worked with them for like 2 years plus, and I got the opportunity to come to the United States. And then when I arrived in the United States, I was here doing my thing, and I got a call from the Voice of America. You know, and I've been with the Voice of America for 7 years now. Doing my radio show, started the African Beats. I produce and host the African Beats radio show. It's a very popular music show across the continent of Africa and other parts of the world. You know, it was an African-based program, but people call me from India, from Brazil, from different parts of it. Somebody called me from, sent me a mail from Japan.
Wow.
And listen, I interviewed somebody from India that always listened to African Beats, an Indian, not an African.
India.
You know? So it's such a huge program. It was a musical program where I talked to music stars from Africa, you know. But I expanded it a little bit because I said Africa has got a lot of talent. We have so much talent. We have book writers. We have actors, you know, producers and all this. So poets. I bring all of them. If you have that talent and you come across me in Washington, D.C., definitely I give you an opportunity, you know. Recently, I spoke to Kanayo, one of the top legendary actors from Hollywood, and I had Vicky Remo, who's a Sierra Leonean publisher. She publishes a magazine called Go
magazine.
You know, all those interviews are coming out. I just talked to Emerson about this his new album, The Last Man Standing, Home and Away. You know, that is causing so much rambling around. You know, so there's a lot, and. I've talked to big guns from Africa like Yvonne Chaka Chaka, you know, talked to Asem in Ghana, talked to some Neji in Nigeria. I was the last journalist to talk to the late Chief Stephen Osita Osadebe of Nigeria, you know, one of the most powerful Afro-Juju musicians. In fact, it was even alleged that he had died while the man was still living. So I had to talk to him. He was in Connecticut. So I had the opportunity of talking to him, you know. So a lot of them come. We are like Josie Chameleon in Uganda. All of them, all those big names come through my show. So, you know, doing all of that, I said, you know, something must be done also for my country. I'm a theater expert, you know, I do a lot of theater plays and all this. So I decided to form what we call the Sierra Theater Productions. At Sierra Theater Productions, I founded because I was looking at the way our cultural heritage was not being displayed here in the diaspora. Our people come here and all of a sudden we lose our heritage, we lose our cultural background. And so if those of us who are elders are losing it, what about the kids that are being born here?
Right.
What about those that are coming, that are young? By the time they grow up, they don't know anything about us.
Definitely.
So I created the African the Sierra Theater Productions. We did, we've done a few plays, like one of the first plays that I did was True Friendship. That play became a very big hit. It was performed at the Kennedy Center, which was one of the biggest theater auditoriums in the world. And we had the opportunity, as the first Sierra Leone theater company, to perform at the Kennedy Center. Did it in New York. After that, I've done other plays like Love Crimes, The Long Awaited Return. I write and produce some of those plays, you know. And gone into a few movies, you know. And I also formed what we call the African Gospel Musical Contest. Wherein I bring together African gospel musicians from different parts of Africa to compete and so that they could be recognized. You know, I didn't want to just make it just like that. I said, come on, I am something. Because the secular musicians are getting all the promotions.
Yeah,
while the African gospel singers, and nobody's recognizing them, nobody's talking about them. We buy their CDs today, we put it in our car, or another family member will take it, and then we pirate it, and that's it. Or we listen to them in church. So we want to bring them together under one roof. And through that, it has been going on for 4 years now, you know, for 4 years now, and we just finished the one in September last year, and we're looking forward to the fifth year come this September. And now we have what we call the African Gospel Network that was created, of which I am the chairman of the African Gospel Network. I have as the public relations director, Gilead Kelly Shoes, and of course the finance person is Mr. Solomon Shoes. So, and we have a board that is we're setting up. In the network, the Gospel Network is comprised of the African Gospel Musical Contest, the magazine, African Gospel Magazine, an African Gospel Radio Station, and African Gospel Television. This is all what we're working towards. But by June this year, the magazine is going to come out. That's going to be the first project. The magazine is in the pipeline now, is in the works, and it will be coming out in June. So with all of that put together, man, yeah, some of those, I don't know.
let me just see. You're talking about your plays. I don't know if, like, this place that you guys are putting up here, do you have any motive or something behind the place, like from plays to a movie, or it's just plays, that's how it stays?
No, well, some of them are going to be transformed into movies. Right. But, you know, see, being a theater person, I don't want that aspect of me to die. I love it when I'm on top of that stage. And I look at the audience in your eye and I talk to you, you know, I look at you in the eye and I talk to you, you know, I love being on stage. That is the difference with the movies. You get the camera, you get the director here, you can be holding on to your script and then you action, cut, let's take it again. Yeah. On the stage, guys, don't cut and take it again. So I love that part.
Yeah.
Every part of your body speaks when you're on the stage. It's like you're in a different world, you know, and I don't want that part of me to die. I still want to do stage work.
I don't know, maybe you can explain to us, because everything I heard coming from you now, African. Why African?
Because I'm an African.
Wow.
And I'm proud.
That's it.
I'm an African.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I can't hide behind anything.
Exactly.
When you look at me, when I got my job at the Voice of America, I was employed because I'm an African. I don't fake it.
Yeah.
I am an
African.
And they want an African for the job. I'm an African for the job. So that will not change.
Right.
I will spend the rest of my life in America. That does not change me. I am still
an African.
In as much as we're having the big gospel contest in September, I want to start going to different states.
Okay.
Like a pre-program before the gospel program in September. You know, that one normally happens down in the Washington, D.C. area.
Right.
You know, I want to start going to different states where we have African churches, that or we have African musicians that we can bring from different places, that we can come and start promoting the program until the big contest.
Okay.
Because we're just not sitting down there. Like, I have this lady from Liberia that always comes, she used to live in Oklahoma. She always comes from Oklahoma for the concert. You know, so we want to take the concert, like a mini series of the concert, to Oklahoma. We want to bring it here to Texas. We want to bring it to different places so that the awareness will grow. So we can be moving. Maybe we'll decide that, okay, 1 year we'll take the finals to another stage. You know, so that's exactly what I'm doing with the gospel concert. Because I want our people, I want when you go on the internet and you say you're looking for African gospel musicians, when you go to the website, www.africangospelmc.org, you'll be able to see exactly what we're talking about. If you go to our website now, you will see a lot of stuff that we have done, pictures of our contestants, you know, past pictures of what we used to do, videos and all this stuff. They are all there.
All right, that's good. And for our viewers, you just heard. So, and I believe one thing, we the people, we have a lot to do. We have a lot to learn. Who are we talking about? You that is watching us now.
Yeah.
We have a lot to do. I don't know if you want to tell us something, because I realize you have a link with the Sierra Leonean movie industry. Can you explain to us how that is coming up?
Well, you know, like you said, I'm an African. That's in that same light, I'm a Sierra Leonean.
Yeah.
And Sierra Leone, well, being a Sierra Leonean makes you an African.
Yeah.
And I want to make sure our industry, whatever we do as Sierra Leoneans or Africans, grow. And because I'm a Sierra Leonean, I don't want to leave that part out. So what I've started doing, movie business in Sierra Leone is growing. So for us to help our brothers and sisters over there, to push them and to make sure we try to circulate their movies here in the diaspora, we've started doing premieres of Sierra Leonean movies that are being shot in Sierra Leone.
Okay.
And Sierra Leonean movies that are also being shot here,
yeah,
that we call, that we all put together in one nutshell, we say African movies.
Yeah.
You know? So like right now, I've been working with Jimmy B. Jimmy Bangura, who is one of the Sierra Leone's finest filmmakers.
Okay.
He produced The Wheel. That movie has been premiered in Maryland, and it has just been premiered in Houston, Texas,
okay,
right here, which is why I'm here today. And we're going to be moving. And immediately after this one, we're going to bring in another movie that was premiered in Maryland, but that one was shot here in the United States. And the producer is Christina Taylor from Prime International, called Nurses from Hell. Nurses from Hell has got 80% Sierra Leoneans in it. So we're going to bring that movie also to Houston and to Dallas, let so that people can see. We want to take it to different places. In April, the movie will premiere in Sierra Leone. So we want, as we're bringing movies that are being shot in Sierra Leone into the United States,
okay,
movies that are also being shot here in the United States by Sierra Leoneans, will be taken to Sierra Leone to premiere. And we're not giving up. I know our people are learning to get used to us in movies because they've been used to seeing other people.
Faces.
Other phases, but now if you look at the screen, like when you watch The Wheel, it got a standing ovation.
It got a standing ovation.
Everybody was saying that the Sierra Leoneans that were there, Nigerians, all the people
all
from
the
different
people
countries
there, yeah,
gave it a thumbs up.
Definitely.
You know, it means we're doing a good job.
Sure.
So, our people, we're not there yet, but we will get there. And we will not stop because we're going to take it to them. We're going to force them to accept us and respect what we do. You know, there used to be a saying in Sierra Leone, it was used negatively, and I'll say that in Creole, that if Osno said you, it's not bad. But you know, at one sometime last year, I was listening to myself saying that, and I turned it over for the positive. I said, if Osno said you, it's not bad. That means, for those of us who are in this world, if our people don't appreciate what we do and talk about us, the world will not know about
us. No.
So let's use that for the positive part of it. You know us. You know what we do. You know what we're capable of doing. And you've been crying for us to do it. Now we have started doing it. We've started doing movies. We're doing good music. Don't bring us down. Tell the world about how good we are and respect what we do. Then the world will know about us.
Sure.
Every day they will say, oh, Peace Corps is this. Oh, this is this Nigeria movie is this. This Africa movie is this. But it is the people of Nigeria that made those stars what they are.
Today.
They sold them to the world.
Mm-hmm.
And the world accepted them. So why can't we sell our own? Well, they're a very small community.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody knows everybody. So if I start talking about a Kemta, I have, when I live here, when I go down to Melbourne, everywhere I go, I'll talk about what Akemta is doing. So everybody will know. So some people are coming to Texas, they're coming to Dallas. They ask, oh, if I want a video, I want to do something. This guy, there's this guy called Akemta. That means I've started selling you out in the positive line.
Mm-hmm.
So that's it.
Yeah, it's kind of hard, but just like you said, I believe with all of you guys watching now, we get in there. We're not there yet, but we're getting there.
Mm-hmm.
It's up to us to help lift up one another in whatever we do in a positive way.
Mm-hmm.
So if Osmo save you, he's
going to
buy you.
That's it.
On the positive end.
On the positive end,
I guess,
use it.
Yeah, if we can just change it, everybody, we change it on a positive end, I believe it's going to work.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to work for a good too in the community.
Of course.
Okay, we want to step in again. I usually ask people this question. If I can take your iPod or whatever you listen to music, what type of songs will I find there? I know, but I usually do.
Trust me,
mm-hmm,
you will find every genre of song.
Okay.
And for now, you will find a lot of African songs. And gospel.
Yeah.
I say a lot of African songs because with the work that I do,
uh-huh,
I deal with African music across the continent.
Mm-hmm.
So for every day, you know, there was a day somebody wrote to me from Nigeria. I have a very big fan base in Nigeria. They have fan clubs, Vandy fan clubs everywhere. He said, David, I thought the best music was from Nigeria. He said, until I started listening to African beats, then I knew that Africa has got talent.
Yeah.
Sure. He said, I listened to music from Ethiopia. I cannot believe that I was actually dancing. I listened to music from Uganda. You take the East African music, it is booming.
Yeah, that's true.
You take the West African music, you go to North Africa. Can you imagine? Maybe we think in North Africa because it is all like Muslims and Arabs, our brothers and sisters that are here. You want to hear something different.
Those guys
are just splendid.
Yeah.
When you listen to their music, man, the world is changing. And Africa is not stepping down. We are changing. We are evolving with the world when it comes to entertainment.
That's true. I believe we are happy to have you on board today.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you have anything to tell our folks out there as a conclusion.
There's always something to say to our people.
Yeah.
One thing I want my people to know is that never despise a small thing.
Oh, definitely.
And don't always look down on yourself. Believe in you. Believe in yourself. Believe in your people. Because if we don't believe in us, nobody else is going to believe in us. Nobody. Now we're here today. If I don't believe in what you're doing as a Sierra Leonean or as an African, nobody's going to look at you.
Not yourself.
We have to believe in ourselves.
Yeah, we shall do.
You know? And as Sierra Leoneans, let me make it so, let me be specific here.
Okay.
Let us stop pulling each other down. I think the best we can do is to make sure if somebody's doing good, we help push that person. Because when we help push that individual, we are pushing an entire country. I look at myself because of where I work as an ambassador of Sierra Leone.
You should.
Somebody said you are an ambassador for Africa. I agree.
That's why I say.
Because if I mess up there,
mm-hmm.
I am not only messing the name David Vandy.
No.
I am messing the name Sierra
Leone.
I am messing the name
Africa. Sure.
So that is why I am there to make sure I prove that. They did not make a mistake. They chose me to get on board, and I am there to represent the continent. So with that, never despise a small beginning.
Any future program?
Oh yes, that one will not stop coming. That one will not stop coming. Before the end of this year, I'm looking forward to doing one of my plays into movies, and I want to do a play. Do one movie and one play that we'll use to go around the country. And of course, the African Gospel Contest is coming up in September, on September 28th, in either D.C., Maryland, or Virginia.
Okay.
We're using one of those states because it's the tri-state around. That's on September 28th. If you want to know more about that, you can go to www.africangospelmc.org. African Gospel, all is one word. African Gospel MC, all is one word. .org. And you will see most of the information there about the African Gospel Contest. So far, that is what we're looking at. And also, we'll be coming back to Houston with the movie Nurses from Hell.
So how, if somebody want to listen to your program, your show, how do we go about that?
You go to www.voaafrica.com, you know, you click on that, you look for African Beach, you go to listen to my show. We have the live stream. On the live stream, if you click on, you put in voaafrica.com, you go to a place where it says listen, and if you click on that, you will see Africa Live, Global Live, and World Live. All of that you can be able to listen to the show. But because of the internet again, whenever I do interviews, very important interviews, I put the link on Facebook.
Okay.
You know, so you can go to Facebook, and if you click on that link, you'll be able to listen to the show at the appropriate time. You know, so we try to make it more accessible. And I also have other internet or other radio stations that actually carry my show, like Africa FM. They carry the show every day. And in other parts of Africa, you have affiliates radio stations that actually broadcast the show.
I believe to keep in touch with Mr. Vandy and all he does, man, it's out there, so it's up to us. We want to say we're pleased having you today and your excellency. I just said it because you are an ambassador for us.
Okay. I do appreciate that. Thank you very much. And I also have the African Beat, Voice of America African Beat Facebook page.
Okay.
People can go there and like the page, you know, and leave their comments. Take some of those comments and read them out on the show.
Okay.
You know, anytime.
Yeah. All right. So we say thank you, and I believe one thing I do get from this talk we have is not an interview. We just had a talk. It's just the same saying that says, "If us not sell you, it not go buy you." On the positive end. So stay blessed. Peace. We never give to the world and peace government.